My name is Claire Masker, and I'm the Communications Director for the National Pork Board. The recent cases of African swine fever in China is a reminder of the negative impact that a trade-limiting foreign animal disease would have on our pork industry. Dr. Dermot Hayes, an economist with Iowa State University, estimates that in the first year of an African swine fever outbreak would cost our pork industry over $8 billion. There are no current cases of African swine fever in the U.S. However, the current situation in China reminds us that it is never too late to prepare for a possible foreign animal disease outbreak here. Joining me today is Dr. Dave Pyburn, Vice President of Science and Technology for the National Pork Board, to talk a little bit more about African swine fever and how producers can prepare now and safeguard their farms from a foreign animal disease outbreak. Welcome, Dave.
Thanks, Claire. Glad to be here.
Can you tell me a little bit more about what is African swine fever?
Yeah, African swine fever, it's a virus. It's also a virus that we've never had in this country. It's one of the big three foreign animal diseases that scares us as far as being trade limiting, because African swine fever is one of them, foreign animal disease is another one, or foot and mouth disease is another one, as well as classical swine fever. If we get any of those three foreign animal diseases, trade will be shut down immediately. So it scares us, because trade, as we know, is a big part of our industry today. So we just cannot have any of these three. And right now, African swine fever in China is scaring us as far as coming into this country.
So can you tell me what the current situation is in China right now?
Yes. As of this morning, we got notice of a fourth case of African swine fever in China. It's in a province, in a part of the country that it continues to move south in China. And that is not good news for us. As it moves south, and it's jumping by hundreds of miles at a time, as it moves south, it's moving closer and closer to the pig dense area of China, where it could get out of control.
So African swine fever has been spreading in Eastern Europe. Why is this outbreak here in China more of a concern?
Yeah, you're right. For the last couple of years, we've been watching as African swine fever has moved through the Caucasus, moved through Russia, and then parts of Eastern Europe. The real fear here is because it's China, and that's because the amount of trade that we do with China. We trade a higher amount of goods with China than we do with those other areas. We also trade more of the at-risk material that could transfer this virus with China. I'm talking about things like amino acids, vitamins, minerals, soybean cakes, organic soybean meal, all of those things that we trade with China. And all of those things have been shown through producer-funded research to be able to harbor the virus on a trip all the way over from China to the point where it finally would get put in front of our animals. So we're concerned. If any of those things come in harboring that virus, we could inadvertently be infecting our pigs.
So if producers are concerned about a possible foreign animal disease outbreak here in the United States, what can they do right now to safeguard their farms?
Right. So this goes for African swine fever, regardless of the situation we have right now. It goes for foot and mouth disease. It goes for classical swine fever. And that, I think, the number one thing to do is fill out the foreign animal disease checklist. This is a checklist that helps you with biosecurity and other things on your farm to prepare for if and when we do have that foreign animal disease. It will also prepare you to get into the secure pork supply program to help with business continuity on your farm in the face of an outbreak. That checklist can be found at pork.org/FAD.
So if you're a veterinarian, what can you do to help your clients prepare today?
I think, again, I'm going to go back to the checklist, and those veterinarians can go up to that same site at pork.org/FAD, pull down that checklist, get it in front of their clients, work with their clients on working through that checklist and fulfilling that checklist. And I think the number one thing on there to do is make sure that every site that is out there has an individual premises ID, and I'm stressing individual. Every geolocated site should have its own premises ID, so then in the face of an outbreak, we can very quickly identify where the pigs are and identify where the disease is versus where the disease is not based on these premises ID numbers.
In your opinion, what is the benefit of taking measures right now today for producers?
I think there's a number of benefits. One is it's always good to have a biosecurity check on a farm. Even if we didn't have this scare today, I would advise that on a regular basis, veterinarians and producers sit down and work through a biosecurity check for the farm, even just for the diseases that we have here domestically. So that's probably the number one thing. Number two is to make sure you have that premises ID number in place. And number three is to get your farm ready overall for a secure pork supply program. that program that in the face of an outbreak will help to enable the regulatory officials to determine the risk of moving animals from your farm. And then if they determine that the risk is low and you can move your animals, we can get business continuity within our industry back up and moving.
And then what is the Checkoff doing today to work with other organizations to keep African swine fever from entering the U.S.?
I'm glad you asked that because we saw this, the first case here August 3rd, and immediately we started working with the National Pork Producers Council, the American Association of Swine Veterinarians, as well as the Swine Health Information Center. We started pulling together where can we pull information from to find out more about what's going on in China, and that continues today and every day. That's how we keep hearing about the new cases as they break in China, is that discovery of information, where we can pull that from, people we can pull that from, and then sharing that amongst ourselves. And then the other thing is that we have done as well is we have put together a letter that goes to USDA to their chief veterinary officer, Jack Shear. And then on that letter, we talk about preparedness and a priority for prevention, of course, for any of the foreign animal diseases, but especially African swine fever in this case, and then also response. We want to make sure that USDA understands that we see the heightened attention that this virus needs and that this foreign animal disease needs at this time, and that we have some questions that we want to make sure get answered so that we can hopefully prevent this, and worst case is that we're ready to respond as soon as it would enter. So we wrote that letter between the four organizations. We've sent that off. We've also had meetings over the phone with that chief veterinary officer for USDA, and we're planning to have a face-to-face sit-down meeting to have some answers to those questions in that letter.
Okay. Well, thank you, Dr. Dave Pyburn, for joining us this afternoon to talk a little bit more about African swine fever. Can you remind producers what they can do today to prepare for a possible foreign animal disease outbreak?
I think the first step is to go to pork.org/FAD, get the foreign animal disease checklist, work through that with your veterinarian, make sure your farm is as secure as it can be and as ready as it can be for a potential foreign animal disease, whatever it may be. The other place to go is securepork.org and take a look at the Secure Pork Supply program. Look at what it takes to be in that program and determine whether it's something you need to do ahead of time so that you can have continuity of business, hopefully, if you have low risk for movement of animals in the face of an outbreak.
Okay. Again, remember to visit pork.org/FAD to learn more. Thank you for joining us.